my darlings. Welcome to another greeting card Thursday. I'm really excited to get going on this one, so I'm just gonna get started right away. Because I'm not feeling as confident in it as some of the other videos we've done. Because today I'm stepping a little bit out of my comfort zone. A friend of mine mentioned to me, a friend who watches my videos, I said to her, what sort of subject do you think I should do for my greeting card Thursday? And she said, well, you've done a lot of characters, maybe you should do something that isn't a character. And I thought that was a great point. So today we're going to be doing a teapot, which I thought was just so kind of on theme for the week, let's say, because last week and the week prior we did kind of tea-themed things, so it just seemed quite apt, and I think that most people find like a teapot to be, you know, pretty aesthetically pleasing. So we're gonna do that. Just using my Prismacolor Blue Verathon to really lightly just kind of put in approximately where I want things to be. Approximately. And then I'm going to go in with, I think, probably a darker pencil afterwards. And just make things a little more visible. Hoping you can see it well. So last weekend, well not the one we just passed, but the weekend prior, I was at Toronto Comic Con. I was a guest there, and it was so much fun. And I got to meet a lot of you, which was just so amazing and cool. Thank you so much to all of you who came and said hi to me and said that you like my ASMR video. It made me so happy. I can't even tell you. I'm really glad that you said hi. And the con was a blast, too. It was really fun. I've been to Toronto Comic Con 2 other times. Twice. But both of the other times was just as a attendee. And it's a very fun con to do. A lot of really good cosplayers. So if you like seeing costumes, it's a great con to check out. I saw a lot of cosplays that I really liked. I tried to tell everyone if they had a costume I liked, but it's hard. Sometimes you just see people in passing. I saw a really good Rapunzel from Tangled. And Sophia the First cosplay, which I've never seen before, and I thought that was really cool. And I saw a couple really great Rey from Star Wars. A couple Reys. And they were all just wonderful. It's so cool too when you kind of see people put their own spin on it. Everyone has that thing that makes them so unique and special. So, gonna kind of put the... Sorry, I'm just trying to... Basically, this little spout here sort of angled, and the handle should be directly diagonal. So because this is kind of just past the profile part of the teapot, the handle should be just beyond it. We shouldn't be able to see where the handle joins the teapot, because we can see where the spout joins it, right? Perspective. So put that there, and then we need like the little handle on the lid here. This. And one of the things that I did at Toronto Comic Con as well, we had a panel, myself and a couple other YouTubers. We had like a YouTube themed panel, and basically we just talked about YouTube stuff. We just talked about and answered questions and gave YouTube advice. It's funny too, because I would even attend a panel like that, because I'm always trying to improve. So like, even though I was giving it, I was also really listening to the other people on the panel for what they thought about things, because I think there's always room to improve our craft, you know? There's always room to do better and better. Okay, and there should be like kind of a little, not too obviously, but a little kind of lip to the bottom of the teapot. I think that's good. It's pretty simple. I'm just gonna erase this right in here. This is a new eraser. It's called a Colorolia Pebble Eraser. I just got it recently. Okay. So, I had this idea, right? I thought that maybe today, because we've never used markers before, it might be fun to use markers. Right? So, let's see. I keep my markers sorted by color. So I have different drawers. I have like pinks and purples. Obviously this is all green, right? It's not that I have that many markers. Just very peculiar about how I store things. And, I don't know. I have no excuses. I know a lot of you will relate, so I have nothing to say in my defense. Biggest thing when working with marker is you really can't go back if you mess up, right? So it's helpful to start with the lightest color and build up shadow, build up the color, you know? It's like watercolor in that way, because you can't really erase marker, right? So we're gonna start with one of these guys, a really light green, and just build up the shadow, build it up. Okay. So, I have this mint cream color, and I have this one, which, interestingly, the color is lime green. It doesn't look very lime green, does it? Okay, so I'm gonna use the chubby end. Start blocking in a couple things. Oh, and here's another tip. It's a really good idea when you're working with marker to have an extra piece of paper nearby just to kind of test markers on. Because sometimes you can think a marker works and it really does not. Teasing you. So, like I said, just starting to lock in some shapes a little bit here. There's gonna be darkness in here, for sure. Hoping that it's not too loud for you. I'm actually in the middle of a rainstorm right now. But I wasn't gonna let that stop me from making a video. Okay, I'm gonna kind of shading in this area. Starting to get a little dry. Can you see that? And then some in here, and this bit will all be dark in here. And probably some more in here too. Yeah, this marker's done. On our way out, it's this mint cream. It's a shame. I remember buying that one very specifically. I just really liked it. Looks about right. Let's see what else. What do we have? What kind of color are you? Chartreuse. Let's see. That looks okay, but I think we'll use this one for right now. Look how dark that is, my goodness. Put the dark in here. And the card stock that these cards are made out of, I don't know if you can tell, they do bleed a little bit. It's not like super, super noticeable, but that is an element to it, so you definitely kind of have to be prepared for that. And I have another color on the go that's a bit darker. It's not quite dark enough. Let's see. It's almost more of a green, but not necessarily a shade change. Dead. I think I found the winner. Yep. I did indeed. Okay. I like to have, yeah, a couple going on at the same time. And that's just kind of my style. Markers kind of blend into each other. Work with them. They're just fussy. I'm a little out of practice when it comes to markers. It's not my forte anymore, though I think it used to be. I used to like work with markers constantly when I was a teenager. Specifically Prismacolors. I have a couple of Copic ones now, which I actually prefer. I've mentioned that in a past video. But, they just don't dry out as fast. Some people call them Copic markers. I don't know, but it really matters what you call. As long as we all know what we're talking about, right? Okay, this should be here. This. Trying to work in some shading. I'll be honest with you, when I'm doing like shading on a surface that's super shiny like this, there's a certain amount of guesswork involved. It might not be like that for everybody, but for me it is. My best advice would be to study photographs. Usually helps the most. I try to do it as much as possible, though clearly not enough sometimes. I have so much to learn still. And I think that's, you know, part of the fun frustration about being an artist. You know, what makes you an artist is that eye. Like, being able to tell if something is aesthetically pleasing and stuff. And one of the annoying parts about that is you can kind of tell when something looks off. So a lot of the time you end up feeling pretty frustrated by our own work, because we're just learning, right? But you have to push past that and not beat yourself up too much. It's all fun. Where it's all about fun and exploration of ourselves. And that's why today we're doing this happy little teapot. Happy, happy little teapot. actually, I mean, none of you will be surprised by this at all, but I actually was watching a Bob Ross stream the other day. He's such an inspiration to me, my goodness. Even though, like, his type of work is not one that interests me on kind of like an aesthetic level, I still have just such an appreciation for him as a person, if that makes sense. I just think that he's done a really cool thing with his life, and I would like to be a little more like that. I'm introducing another marker here. Clearly I was not satisfied with just the one. That's how it goes with me. I should do some up here too. Underneath this. I'm not usually one to use green, too. This is kind of out of character for me, isn't it? I hope I don't worry you. Nothing's wrong. Just trying to do something different. Don't send me any worrisome messages, you know. Why aren't you using pink today? Just trying to branch out a little bit. Do something different. Even I am capable of surprising you sometimes. And this should kind of come up. I'll just leave that open. Sorry if I'm getting a little quiet. I'm just actually like concentrating now. Oh, right, we need to make this guy dark. A little bit more in here. And I think I need to do some more work up in this hand a bit, because I really haven't done much at all. Not much at all. Yeah, markers bleed a lot, and If you're smart, you'll take advantage of that. I don't know that I've necessarily been super smart in this instance. I think halfway through it, I kind of realized that was going to happen. And just tried to take advantage. Trying to build up lots of shading in here. I also like have my gel pen, so if we wanted to do some highlights at the end, you know, we could. I don't really know if I want to though. I would kind of like to avoid it, but I feel like I'll probably end up doing it anyway in typical Ange fashion. Adding little sparkle highlights. Sounds about right, eh? Personally, I really like the sound of markers. I used to really like, when I was little, I had these, like, smelly markers. I think it, like, basically everybody had these markers as a kid. And when you would color with them, the sound would be so strong. Like, so strong. It was almost cartoonish. Like, how can it possibly be that silly of a sound? If that makes sense. But it was real, and I used to love coloring with them because of that. Because of the ridiculous sound they would make. So I have this gray. Yeah, that looks okay. Alright, I'm gonna kind of do a little outline, on the outside, just here, and then marker. Well, it's like a pen almost. I don't know if it's a pen or a marker. You've probably seen me use this before, actually. It's a Kure Take. That might be the brand. I got it actually from a friend of mine who lives in New York. But from my understanding, you can buy these pens at a lot of, like, Japanese places that sell stationery. For example, Mitsuha in New Jersey, Kinokuniya in New York. These sorts of places. And they're not very expensive at all. And I kind of like it because, I don't know if you can see, the tip is pointed, and it makes doing little stuff like this really nice. It's for details, but it's still so bold. I really like it. And the handle. I feel kind of okay about how this turned out. I feel alright about it. It's definitely out of my comfort zone. I think it's a little crooked, but that's okay. We'll just say we did it on purpose. That's what art is all about. Happy little accidents. And it is pouring outside. But, you know, that's a sign of spring, isn't it? Spring's never gonna come unless it rains. So I say, bring on the rain. The more the merrier. Maybe a little more in here. Just thinking about the lid. Yeah, this teapot's a little crooked, but it'll just be a teapot from Alice in Wonderland. That's what we'll say. And now, I'm hoping this gel pen show up. So I'm gonna do some little highlights. So, okay. This is what I'm talking about. I like this. Good, good, good. Let's see, I'm doing like this. Kind of. Do something like this. I think there should be some light coming around the corner here. We'll make sure that this highlight is good. Like that. Just around the corner here. Extra shiny. You can just imagine all the steam coming out. And I think we should do some cute little hearts to kind of wrap it all up. But I will put the lids back on these markers so that they don't dry out. Okay. What do you think of our teapot so far? It's definitely different from what we usually do. But I'm having fun. Oh, that is very neon. That is on its way out. That's a dry marker right there. Oh, you know what? I have these Tombow switch you guys have seen me use. so many times. I feel like I'm constantly using them. And they're nice because they have this brush tip. Looks like that. So nice for doing lettering, but also for shading. You can do a lot of different like kind of marks with them. So they're nice. To add something cutesy. It wouldn't be me if I didn't do this, okay? That's what we will tell ourselves. Alright, so last thing, guys. We always have to sign our piece. Something a little different for this week's greeting card Thursday. Although not different for my channel, because we're all about the tea here the last couple weeks. Anyways, you guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope that you enjoyed it. I love you so much, and I'll see you soon. Bye!